The host can control the settings for all participants who are in the virtual room. When you click on the Participants button in the down right corner, you can see a list of all the people into the room. You have control over participants' microphones and cameras. When they are green, they are active. If the host mutes them, they turn red and a small padlock appears. The participant is not allowed to unmute. When a participant mutes their microphone or camera, they just turn red. When you click on the Settings button on the right, a new menu opens. It allows you to manage participants' access to certain functionalities in the virtual room. You have the option to disable the participant's microphone and speaker or to adjust their level. Then you may choose to have this participant in an individual video. You can do it by activating this button. Click on it to turn green. By default, the host is in an individual video and participants are in the video mosaic. The next settings are for screen sharing. They are active by default. The participant can share their screen and see the screens of others when they are shared. You may decide to change this by deactivating these buttons. The next group is about the whiteboard. By default, participants are allowed to see the whiteboard, write on it, and edit all objects. You may change these settings from these buttons. Last in this group is the presenter permission. You may assign presentation permission to a participant by activating this button. In this case, they will be able to create and edit the whiteboard pages, turn on the presentation mode, control the media player, and share files from the library on the whiteboard. Then you may decide to deny permissions for the chat, which are allowed by default settings. There are three options: reading the messages in the chat, writing in the chat, and having a chat with an individual participant. The last group of settings is about the file library, giving you the options to allow or deny permissions for uploading files from participants' device onto the file library and to download files from the file library. By default, settings uploading is denied while downloading is allowed. Finally, there is a button which allows you to ban a participant. When you press the ban button, the participant is logged out. The host has the option to control the settings for each participant separately or for all participants at once. To change the setting for all participants, click here. The settings are the same as in the individual control menu, but this time you need to press allow or deny for each option. The menu looks different to avoid confusion. In this way, it's easier for the host to know if they are changing the permissions for only one participant or for all of them together. Note that even if you change the permission for all participants, the next participant who enters the room will have the default permissions.